We saw the systems issues at a macro level from the point of view of administering the engine that powers internet-scale computing. How do we program services such as web search and airline reservation on top of the data center cluster resources? How do they exploit the hardware parallelism that's available in these clusters? We will learn about the MapReduce programming paradigm that answers these questions. The term big data has become a buzzword. Computations in giant-scale services are usually simple, but they work over large data sets, and hence the name big data. And naturally, because they're working with a large data set, these computations take a long time to compute. For example, let's say that I want to search for John F. Kennedy's photographs in all the documents that are available on the web. It's going to take a long time, and that is an example of a big data computation. Similar examples include online reservations, shopping, etc. And applications that work on big data would like to exploit the parallelism that's available in the cluster at the data centers. I mentioned in the last lesson that data centers these days comprise of computational elements on the order of thousands and even 10,000 nodes that are ready to do computations. And we would like to exploit the computational resources available in such big data centers to do computations on big data. For example, if it is John F. Kennedy's photographs, I'm looking in all the different documents, we can parallelize the search for Kennedy's photo in all the documents in parallel on all the available nodes in the data center. And such computations are also called embarrassingly parallel computations. What does this mean? Well, there is not much synchronization or coordination that is needed among the parallel threads that comprise the applications and that run on different nodes of the computational cluster. Looking for John F. Kennedy's photographs in all the documents on the web is a good example of such an embarrassingly parallel application. What are all the issues in programming in the large on large data sets? So the data sets are also large, and the computational resources on which we want to run this big data application is also vast. So some of the interesting issues in programming in the large include how to parallelize an application across, let's say, 10,000 machines, how to handle the data distribution and plumbing between the producers of data and consumers of data. Remember, these are embarrassingly parallel applications, but different phases of the application will require data from one phase of the application to be passed on to the next phase of the application. That's what we mean by plumbing between the producers of data, intermediate data to be more specific, and consumers of that intermediate data. And of course, one of the biggest challenges in big data applications on large computational clusters is failure handling. Recall what we said about the nature of these data centers. They employ thousands and thousands of processes. When you have so many parts in any setting, failure is not a question of if it will happen, it is a question of when it is going to happen. So that's a fact of life, and therefore programming models for big data have to worry about the fact that failures are to be expected in this environment.